So good of you to join me tonight. I'm Leonard Nimrod, and this is Nightmare Gallery. Before you join me, I was just perusing this vintage copy of Spooky Tales, three of which we are going to highlight tonight on tonight's show. Our first tale, submitted for your approval, is aptly titled Silent But Deadly. It involves Harry Hickman, a 54-year-old papoose who has taken silent movies a little bit too seriously. For it may not only cost Harry his sanity, but it may cost him his life. For Harry has hit the mute button once too often, and he will forever be closed captioned in the trenches of Nightmare Gallery.
They just don't make them like they used to.
Don't believe him, guys. Harry's not coming. He's reading stupid crap.
What book would be so interesting it would fail to keep him from coming?
Brace yourselves, boys. He's reading a Charlie Chaplin biography. Can you believe that?
You're pulling our leg, right?
No way. Cross my heart. Hope to die. That's the honest truth, yes, mister.
What is wrong with that fella? Yeah, last month he begged off going to see Iowa Cubs baseball game in the chief seats to go to some Rudy Valentino film festival.
And now this to top it off.
That Harry, he's such a silent movie fanatic fella.
He eats and drinks that stuff.
Yeah, you'll never guess, boys. He's thinking about actually officially changing his name, legally, to Charlie Valentino or Fatty Fairbanks, is it? Who are these people?
Fanatic's not the right word either. Cuckoo bird!
Have you noticed that all Harry ever wears is his old goofy shirts with the old actors on them?
Or, you know, one day he could regret this wild obsession he has with silent movies.
Yeah, buddy.
Word.
Cold drink will wake me up. Oh boy.
Thank you.
Oh my, that was felt real. Oh my. Ooh, I don't like dreams like that. What a relief. I don't know. Boy, my body aches. My shoulders are killing me. Not to mention my knees. I feel like I've been hit by a Mack truck. I don't know what's going on here. And my left arm, it's just burning. Like, I don't know what's going on with it. Ugh. What is going on? Happening to me?
Excellent, excellent tale. A feast for all freaks. Our second helping on the menu is a little entree called Talking Back to the Night. It's a tale of a radio talk show host named Nick Gusto, who has lost his inspiration. Unfortunately for Nick, once he finds said inspiration, he will have whiffed the foul stench of pure evil, served up in a cardboard box and mailed first class to an unearthly address in Nightmare Gallery.
Segment of the nation's number one radio talk show that is devoted to unsolved mysteries and outrageous conspiracy theories. I'm your host, Nick Gusto, and this is Talking Back to the Night. We would like to thank our two esteemed guests for appearing on the big show today. First, Charles Berlitz, for his insight into missing aircraft over the Triangle, which he sheds new tidbits of information in his new bestseller, Sinister Clouds Over Bermuda. And of course, mob informant Gino Stroganoff, who was here to shamelessly plug his latest children's book, Where in the World is Jimmy Hoffa? All right, Kelper, let's open the phone lines and see what you, the public, have on your minds on this beautiful fall evening. We have Norb from Altoona, Iowa on the line. Norb is on the air and he is talking back to the night.
Hi, Nick. I love your show. So glad you're on the air after Art Bell retired.
Thanks, Dick. What you got for us tonight?
Well, Nick, this might sound crazy, but I think a headless motorcycle rider is trying to kill me, and the rest of our biker gang, the South Dakota Dirty Nuts.
Well, you're right, Norb. You do sound crazy. And please, for the love of Pete, lay off the old Milwaukee. And our last call of the day comes from Kenny in Platteville, Wisconsin. Kenny, you are on the air and talking back to the night.
Third time caller here, Nick. Man, we love your show here in the land of cheese.
Right on, man. We're kicking it with Kenny. Tell us what's on your head, brother.
Well, yesterday I bought some yellow fudge cookies and left them on the kitchen counter overnight. During the night, I heard little clucking and moving sounds coming from said kitchen. I just thought maybe it was the cat. I get up this morning and I find my whole kitchen has been rearranged and the cookie box is gone. I'm thinking the keyboard owl came off the box and are trying to mess with my head.
Well, that wouldn't be too hard now, would it, Kenny? Just cut back on the sugar intake and eat more greens, Ken. Well, that's all the show we have for you tonight on this 19th of October. I once again would like to thank our guests, my engineer Kelper, Funk, and especially you listeners, for you are the voice that rings the alarm for all those mysteries that must be solved. From Shadow People to the Jersey Devil, from D.B. Cooper to Amelia Earhart, from Bigfoot to UFO to ELO to the shores of Loch Ness, raise those voices, ring that alarm, shout into the darkness, and always keep talking back to the night.
Well, that's a wrap.
Keebler Elves, people are getting nuttier every day. I'm beginning to think I need to find a new line of business. I can't take these people seriously anymore, Kelper.
Oh, who's just a little burned out, Mac?
Burned out? Indeed, all I talk to is crazy people on this show. My kingdom to do a serious, thought-provoking radio program. Not this three-hour round table with escapees from a loony bin.
Now, hold on, Nick. I know you. He used to believe in all this loony bin bullcrap.
Keebler Elves, headless motorcycle troopers. Come on, man. There are no such things as Bigfoots or Nessies or little green men from Mars. Kelper, never, ever has there been one shred of evidence of either of them. I'm just a sellout doing this show. I don't believe in anymore.
A rich sellout. Nick, I have somebody I want you to meet. A guy that really needs your help. He really loves the show. Big celebrity, not crazy cat either. Wants to meet us this afternoon. He really believes that something strange is going on here in town. He wants to bend your ear.
Oh yeah? Who is it?
George Yarmulke. king of the Moog synthesizer.
Wow. But why doesn't he just call into the show?
He don't want to get lumped in with all those crazies on your show.
Wow.
I got to be on the grill in 30 minutes. Come on. You need to get out of the studio and get some air. Besides, maybe listening to a guy who isn't a nut will make you feel different about little purple Martians and the legend of Beastfoot.
Martians are green, Kelper. What's Beastfoot?
I'd like you to meet my good friend.
Oh yes, Giorgio Moroder, champion master of the Moog synthesizer.
Yes, the pleasure is all yours.
Oh yes, I met Giorgio at Ingham Okoboji's. My second job as the master chef.
Kelper Funk, you're truly a magician with the spatula.
Gentlemen, I'd love to chit-chat, but I am an important man with many important items on my agenda.
Well, Nick, Giorgio called me with some very distressing news. That you could be one man that could avert an impending disaster.
Well, Giorgio, master of the Moog synthesizer and 1970s chick magnet, you have my interest piqued.
Yes, we'll need a more private place to speak. Yes, they are all around us. Yes, the walls have ears. I know a place where we can go. But please, let's try to keep a low profile. We do not want to call attention to ourselves.
Giorgio Moroder does not advertise.
Baby, what's your secret? I'll let you know. let your arrow fly. Judging all the angles with an eagle's eye, yeah. Cause if you're thinking I'll be loving you, you're right on target. Love is an arrow, shoot me through and through.
Well, this should be private enough.
Well, gentlemen, I have to get over to the Okoboji. This spatula awaits.
So what is this all about, Giorgio?
Squirt. Soda zombies. And an alien being known as Voltor.
Huh?
Perhaps this place wasn't as private as I thought it was. Nevertheless, last month I started receiving strange messages on my Moog synthesizer. I deciphered these communications and realized they were coming from the planet Venus. Millions and millions of miles away.
How could you get messages on your Moog?
Giorgio Moroder has high-tech equipment.
Okay, go on.
I believe, from these intercepted messages, Voltor wants to invade Earth and use humans as slaves to take back to Venus in order to harvest coveted space diamonds. Yes.
Wait a minute. None of us humans will stand for any of this crap.
He is turning people into soda zombies to do his bidding for him. That rascal.
Soda zombies? Are you blitzed?
Squid soda is the vehicle he uses to dumb us down, Mr. Gusto.
I just can't believe any of this crap.
I was just finishing up a track from my new album. With a great mustache comes great responsibility. You can buy this new CD at Kmart for $12.99, by the way. When I received a visit from the great trumpeter Chuck Mangione. Chuck Mangione. I welcomed him in. Something didn't seem right about Chuck. He seemed rather ill at ease. So I asked him what was the matter. He told me that some friends of his were acting rather strangely. One of these such friends was Barbara Streisand, the Emmy Award-winning artist. I told him not to worry because she was a nutty blonde too. But Chuck said there were others, many others in his life that were acting rather strangely. And the strange coincidences was that they had taken to drinking the soda pop squirt soda shortly before their change. I suggested to Chuck, why don't we go down and jam a little, maybe cut a few tracks. That seemed to cheer him up somewhat. He agreed, but he said he needed to have a smoke first. There you go. Thank you. It was very odd. The great trumpeter, Chuck Mangione, had seemed to have disappeared into thin air. I looked everywhere, but because of time constraints, I won't be looking for very long. For several hours, I tried to contact anyone who knew the whereabouts of Chuck Mangione, but to no avail. It was as if he had disappeared off the face of the earth. Suddenly, Chuck Mangione reappeared on my deck. I welcomed him back in. I asked him, "Where were you, Chuck?" Something seemed strange about him now. He said he was sorry he left, but he was parched and he needed a drink. I noticed he was holding a squirt, so I asked him why he was drinking that particular soda after he had told me his friends had started acting so strangely after ingesting it. I suggested that perhaps he should drink something a little more like this. He said he was mistaken before, and that it was actually a great tasting beverage, and that perhaps I should try it. I flat out rejected it. I felt uneasy. It was as if the man standing in front of me was not Chuck Mangione, but some lifeless caricature of the trumpeter. My unease increased 100-fold with the appearance of Barbara Streisand in my kitchen. Barbara said for me to drink the delicious soda, and I would feel like a new man. I told them that I would drink the squirt, but first, I had to use the restroom. I was contemplating my next move, when suddenly I was bull-rushed by Barbara Streisand.
I was going to lose my life in this encounter with these strange soda zombies. I had to think quickly, or else I was going to lose this battle.
I was nearly going to succumb to this onslaught when I remembered a martial arts move that William Shatner once taught me, the lethal quick chop. It was like William Shatner had taken over my body. It was later that night that I first started hearing cryptic messages over my Moog synthesizer. From what I had learned, Voltor had set up a base in Des Moines and was working in conjunction with the honchos at Squirt Bottlers, were zombifying the populace. Voltor is very mighty and powerful, and will stop at nothing to get what he wants. He is flooding the airwaves with squirt commercials, and if my instincts are correct, he will try to use your show for his propaganda, Nick Gusto. Needless to say, he must be stopped and destroyed.
That was the most ridiculous but amazing account I have ever heard of.
Whatever you do, stay away from anyone drinking squirt, or even holding one for that fact. And do not ever, ever drink one sip of this soda. It is terrible and will do nasty things to you.
Hold on. Let me give you my number so you can get in contact with me before you leave. Nuts! Not again. This crap always happens to me. Man, I got a bad back. I'm getting too old for this stuff. Ugh. I should have worn my back brace today. I knew it. Nuts! Is already.
Join us! Join us, you must!
But I'm not thirsty. Okay. Seriously, I'm not thirsty.
Delicious. It tastes good.
Oh no, not at this juncture. I'm receiving my 1984 back orders from Sports Illustrated.
Now and then.
Most people go right for your colas or your clear drinks, but I'm going to recommend a juicy soft drink. Squirt.
This Memorial Day, cool off with the refreshing taste of Squirt.
Softest big drink. To first, last, thirst.
French fries, onion rings, enchiladas. Squirt never met a thirst that couldn't burst, because there's a burst of real citrus juice in every squirt.
A thirst just in citrus, super squirt.
Well, maybe there is something to this squirt conspiracy. You know, watching those squirt commercials kind of makes me kind of thirsty. But I'm not going to be drinking no squirt, that's for sure. Get it nice and cold. Yeah. What the heck's going on here? What the Sam Hill is going on with that stupid door? Crying out loud. What on God's green earth are you doing here? Utopia. Oh crap! This is really not good! I gotta get out of here!
When you drink it, so taste and drink deeply.
Not now, maybe later.
You're strong-willed, Nick Gusto, but you must drink the squirt and be the mouthpiece to Voltor and his minions.
No.
The mighty Voltor has not traveled millions of miles to be thwarted by a 2-bit radio hack. Craig, drink the squirt. drink it. I compare you to drink the squirt.
Actually, we have the top-rated program in the Metro.
I command you to drink the squirt and become part of the Voltour movement.
You know, it does kind of look tasty. Boy, I am kind of thirsty. Yeah. Well, maybe a sip. Yeah. Just a sip.
Yes, drink the squirt! Yes!
Has lifted. Pepsi 1, Voltar 0.
Do not be strong-willed.
I am going to destroy you, Voltar, with the purifying power of fire. Prepare to die! Yes!
Wait a minute, where am I? That was not my recording studio.
Giorgio Moroder! I thought you were under the spell of that diabolical Voltar.
Perhaps when you destroyed Voltar, it broke his hold on all his minions. Besides, Giorgio Moroder is way too cool to be under the control of such a piece of crap. I think I will make a conceptual album out of this whole experience.
Now look who's here. It's our favorite record producer, Giorgio Moroder.
Yes, Nick Gusto. I want to thank you again for for destroying Voltor and making the Moyen safe again for carbon-based life forms. Now I'm going to be heading out to Los Angeles, Hollywood, California. I'm going to produce a spoken word album for Sheriff Cletus called, well, I don't know yet.
Well, as you know, I'm not feeling that well. After smelling the burning fumes, the molten ash of that Voltron.
Well, gentlemen, I have a plane to catch. And you know, time is money, especially for the great Giorgio Moroder. Ciao.
Shaking hands is for sucks. Record producer here needs a hug.
Yeah.
See that bear game watch life? And now we will pause for station identification. But first, a special announcement from our sponsors at Squirt, the beverage of choice. So grab a Squirt and then go take one.
Has been lifted.
Why you wet, fool? For I am Voltor, and you look thirsty.
Wow, that wet my palate. For our final tale from the manure spreader, we join a trio of blonde-headed, dim-witted Nimrods who join a veritable rock legend on case number 4, the Whopper from Watrous. But for these gentlemen, believing is not always seeing. The Spirit Finders, according to the Nielsen ratings, are blowing in the wind. A supercell is about to unload, so seek refuge in a storm shelter in the bowels of Nightmare Gallery.
And the words of wisdom are triggered and forgotten. I'm Ned Fogarty, and I do the jobs that nobody likes to do. Plunge these suckers down. I've been doing this since... I've been doing this since 1987. Yeah, I remember it like it was yesterday. I was tussling with this big old turd, and he would not go down for anything. I finally got him down. It's amazing I'm still doing this after all these years. Well, anyhow, I got into doing this kind of work because I had an experience a while back ago. I heard this voice coming from the stool. It sounded like a Billy Joel song, but as closer as I listened, I kept hearing it. And the song was Pressure. And not Pressure Push on Down, Bushing Down on Me by David Bowie. This was the Billy Joel classic. And from then on, that was my calling. I started a company called Spirit Finders. And I've been doing this ever since.
Time just playing video games with my nephew, Robbie. I had never had a job in my life. I get a call from Ned Fogarty, a good old friend of mine. He said he had a job for me. He said something about wanting to know if I wanted to tussle with spirits and ghosts. I'm like, I'm up for anything. Does it pay good? I said, no, probably not, but we should get out of the room and put some deodorant on. I'm like, cool! Our first outing was my first experience with a ghost or an entity. And then I knew from then on that this was definitely my calling. I didn't plunge toilets like some people, but I feel like now that I'm probably the finest of the three ghost hunters. Fogarty, I know of a guy that can be a help to make us a good threesome to fight against the spirits. Bruce Claghorn. We call him Foghorn Claghorn. He's not available right now to talk about his experiences because he's in the crapper.
Well, boys, we got ourselves one heck of a grinder sting here.
All right.
All we know so far is it's Maryland. And this is the place. I sure hope it's worth our time, you know. I mean, we're kind of missing a football game over this. And I hope she pays cash up front. So I'm not leaving without it.
Okay. I hope it's better than the last case we were involved in.
What was the last one? I don't remember.
You know that case, remember?
A kid from Maryland?
You know, we thought it was some real hunting, and it turned out a bunch of hoodlums were inhabiting that old mansion on 1414 Mockingbird Lane.
Oh, yeah. The house next to...
What a bummer, dude. What a bummer.
Yeah, we sure got rolled in that one, didn't we, guys?
We sure did.
Lighting the wallet after that one. So, how about the celebrity guests we have this weekend?
Yeah, it's great. Yeah. Come on, dude. Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, new celebrity guest. Yeah.
Hey, by the way, does anybody know who a celebrity guest is?
I don't think any of us know.
Fogarty?
Well, guys, we should probably get inside because... Get dark soon. Gargoyles will be coming out.
Yeah. Well, I don't want that to happen.
I know.
Much respect, guys. Like
this. Guy, this place looks like it has lots of paranormal possibilities, Claghorn.
What do you think, Gus?
This is
drainage.
Gonna, this is going to be scary.
I wonder how the drainage is in this place.
I hear dogs barking.
I hope it's dogs, not just... ghosts. This place has oodles of paranormal possibilities, Claghorn.
Yeah.
Well, Gus, what do you think? How do you think the drainage is?
All I know is I got some really good vibes about this place.
Yeah. You think there's a lot of spooks in there?
I think so.
I think a lot.
I think we hit the jackpot. Yeah.
Well, there is.
Okay.
Hey, guys, guys. There's a chick. There's a lady in there washing a chicken in the sink.
Well, that's not scary.
No, it's not.
Oh, boy.
We're in for a treat tonight.
Get salmonella for sure.
Yeah. Oh, boy. That is scary stuff.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, fellas.
Hold on.
Hey.
Seems to me you guys were missing something.
What?
I don't know.
It's our celebrity.
Everything's all here.
You guys are a bunch of ditzy blondes with our celebrity guest.
Oh, yeah.
And he's here.
He's coming down the street now. Yeah.
Well, she's here. He's knock, knock, knocking on this door here pretty quick.
Wow.
You know.
Would you look at that?
We got a show
for her. Guys, this is sweet. Burkini Rogers!
No, you idiot. That's Bobby Goldsboro.
Goldsboro? Wrong Jew. Bob Dylan! Bob Dylan!
Sweet! He must be straight because it don't look like him.
Oh, yeah.
Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan's at Ghost Hunters.
I'll be Ghost Finders. Ghost Finders? Spirit Finders, Claghorn. Get the right show. That was canceled 2 years ago.
Bad ratings.
Bob Dylan, I've been a big fan of your last face for 10 years.
Shaking hands is for socks.
Bring it on. Come on. Wayne's got a hug with their favorites on Dylan.
I knew.
I knew my
manager. He got me this gig. He said that you saw a spirit on a big brass band.
Well, that's what they said.
Dylan, you cracked me up, man. Yeah, they did. He pulls a grass and got in your belly. Sorry, be cool.
Come on, we don't want to keep Dylan waiting.
Come on, dude.
Yeah.
I got a bad gig to go.
Come on, man.
That's be Mayor Horvath. Yeah, get open the door. Spirit Finders in the flesh.
That's us.
Come on,
yeah.
Quiet. Well, I'm glad you guys came. I'm really needing a lot of help, guys.
Yeah.
I appreciate everything
you
could do for me if you can. I've had a lot of problems.
That seems to be the trouble.
Well, I've had things flying with nobody there. Just all of a sudden, it just... Objects have come up and flown around, and I've had weird looking, it looks like shadows of people, but I'm not sure what it is. I thought at first it was just my mind.
Classic paranormal
experience. That sounds like some of the experiences I used to have.
Oh, Dylan.
That wasn't paranormal, Bob.
Yeah, that's something else. So, can you take us to the hot spots?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Follow me.
Okay.
Paranormal activity.
Yeah, right, dude. Yeah.
Hi guys, why don't you just follow me? This is the first place that I've noticed problems.
Bob.
The Angel of our Beauty. What room is this?
Thank you.
This is the
room.
The room?
Yeah.
The
room.
Yeah. All right, guys. This spot is really major. It's one of the spots where I've had a red spot actually form on the floor here. And 1 minute it's there and then it's gone. And it's like it's something that occurs every night, it seems like.
Is there a certain time or just
It can be between midnight and 3 that I've noticed this up here on there. But I never seem to be able to catch it on film.
Okay.
And then the weird thing about this is I've read up in a history book that this house actually was built in 1893, and there was a husband and wife here named Sarah and John McFarvey, and there was a
What do you make of this story so far, Bob?
Something smells about
it. Well, John was... Well, I heard tell that... but I actually seen it in the history books. That John was a wealthy landowner, and he lost all his money in a bad deal. Well, instead of wanting to tell his wife, he stabbed her, and then he shot himself. Well, he really didn't shoot. He shot himself, but it didn't work, so he hung himself. So...
What was the method of what he hung himself with?
I heard it was a belt.
I thought the shower curtain rings.
Maybe he didn't do it for us because he took a belt before he did it.
All right, in this area here, we were eating dinner, and I had a fork, and next thing you know, the fork goes out of my hand, flies across the room, and embeds itself into the wall. And it's like, you know, that scared me half to death. I didn't know somebody could have gotten hurt, one of my dogs could have gotten hurt. I just think sometimes there's a lot of dangerous stuff happening.
You don't think that it could have slipped out of your hand, could it?
Yeah. No, it literally lifted out of my hand and flew through the air, embedded into the wall. There's no strong idea. Stop telling me I'm a liar.
Well, we have to explore every avenue.
That is interesting. So over here, we're going to...
Yeah.
What are we looking at over here?
All right. In this area here, I saw an apparition of a man hanging. And, I mean, it really scared me. He opened his eyes and smiled, and then he just disappeared. So I don't know what... It was so quick. I couldn't... You know, one minute...
This is real short to be hanging in here.
He had to be...
Was he a midget?
He couldn't have been dangling too much.
Was he a dwarf?
He might have been a dwarf.
I heard he was only 3'5".
So he was a small guy.
Yeah.
Midge.
Yeah.
So when he stabbed his wife, would he stab her in the knee?
He used a ladder.
Yeah. All right, guys, let's go upstairs. There's two more things I want to show you up here.
Watch out for that dog, Playgore.
I'm falling out.
Who does your carpeting?
Ooh, this is scary. Oh, man.
Here. You got something up here for us?
Yeah. Yeah. It's right here in the bathroom.
John.
The crapper, huh?
Shut off. Okay. In the bathroom, the lights here, they flickered. And then all of a sudden, I seen the curtain do this.
So the light flickered and the curtain shot open.
Yeah, flickered. Wow.
And the curtain just violently opened up.
Scary.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ooh.
That is interesting.
I'm just glad I wasn't in the shower at the time.
Did it
close back?
No.
What about Bob Dylan's thought time this?
No.
What about that?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, Marilyn, is this the final room?
Yes, it is.
I hope so. I'm getting kind of tired.
Yeah.
What's going on in this one?
Well, in this room, the treadmill here, I was actually laying down to go to sleep, and all of a sudden I heard it turn on, and it started going with nobody on it. And then all of a sudden it just shut itself off.
Very mysterious. Where in the world's Claghorn?
And I heard, you know, like thumps, like somebody was actually running on the treadmill itself.
But you never saw nothing?
No, I did not see anything.
You weren't dreaming?
No. But I did smell...
Sulfur?
No. It was like perfume, like the smell of a lady perfume.
Mm.
And I don't know if that was who it was or not, because I never did get a seat.
I see the problem. Your cord's frayed.
Well, I'm afraid not.
What?
I actually saw what I saw. And it actually did go on its own and start moving on its own.
Tell
Well, Marilyn, some interesting things going on here.
Sure is, Marilyn.
I think we could get to the bottom of this for you.
Awesome.
So, awesome. You just probably need to step out for a few hours and let us bring our equipment in. We'll get set up and we'll go from there. And hopefully we find something. Maybe we'll capture it and then we'll have something to show you.
That would be great. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
Very welcome. Another good cookie. They ain't hot about it.
No.
Bob Dylan had one, too.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much, guys.
See you later, Marilyn.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
We'll have everything cleared up when you get back.
Go ahead and get this stuff in here. We got an hour and a half.
Are you the ghost of something that's haunting this place? Why don't you come on out? Have a conversation with me. Why are you haunting this poor defenseless woman? What was that? Are you in here? There is something definitely strange in this room. I can hear it. Like a bunch of knocking on that cabinet over there. Why don't you come on out? I'm not going to ask again. You're going to make me mad. You said there was blood down here, but I'm not seeing any. Strange. Is anybody out there? Come on now.
Over here.
Yo, Fogarty!
Yes.
Bob Dylan wants to know what year Disco Dave blew out his pants in the Super Bowl.
It was 76, you knob.
I thought it was 75.
It was 76.
I guess you're right.
Then get to work.
All right.
Man, I'm not finding nothing here. Man, screw this. I'm going to go out and smoke.
I haven't saw anything yet.
I don't have any readings there, Claiborne.
Neither do I, Gus.
How you doing back there, Bob?
You guys don't see that really good. You know what I mean?
See what?
This is like freaking going, man.
Dude, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Right there.
Don't you see him? I do see it, Bob. This curtain seems...
It's right there. Right where the food is.
Dude, Bob, we don't see a single thing.
Hey, don't you see him there?
I see it. No, I see it. Clayhorn, I see it. This curtain moved.
You know something, Gus? You're right.
That just told me when I'm riding in my car.
Yeah, there it is.
There it is.
The curtain's moving right there.
These chair curtains. Yeah, it's almost like...
I think it's about time that I go home.
Oh, my.
That is truly a great reading.
That's a truly a great phenomenon.
Right there, guys. Right there in between.
I could use a snack.
That's good.
I don't
know what to do.
Yes,
that's
too. Hey. There's lots of pure
land
activity in this room.
Sure is, Gus. Bob, I don't see a darn thing, Bob.
We're gonna have to get a better celebrity guest. That curtain's moving again. Or whatever that is, some kind of prop.
Whoa!
I feel a breeze, Bob.
That is sweet.
You're right. There's something over here.
It is truly.
The engine, my friend, is blowing in the wind.
There's truly a presence here, Gus. Bob, I don't see a thing, but
I'm not getting a reading there.
You see that?
It's getting stronger there, though.
You see that thing move?
I see.
Wow, Gus.
I don't see it move. I see him move.
I don't see anything, Gus. I see. Wow, Gus. That was truly a spectacular.
I don't think we've ever, in all our episodes, this is the fourth episode, we've never had a paranormal experience like this.
Man, he's really gone.
I think we gotta go to another room, Gus. There's probably some far greater phenomenon that we could experience.
I know what you're saying. I wish you remember what that other guy's name was. I talked to him real quick.
Good.
You're right. It's an air current through the door.
Yeah, there's some current through the door. I used to be current, now I'm gone.
Yes, Bob, I do feel the air current.
Yeah, Gus, you're absolutely right. There is a current coming from the top of that door. Yeah.
Where's Bogarty when you need him?
I don't know. He's probably off taking a dump.
He's coming on the bayou.
He can take a dump in the dark.
Wow.
Yeah, I do feel
the
presence.
Definitely a current.
I feel a
current. There's no physical... activity going on here.
Let's try the next room.
Forget it.
You're in the wrong movie.
See. It's unlocked.
creeps in here.
What?
Well, he's got a lot of junk.
Nice clock. Good luck, boys. I'm gonna get me some Z's.
Hey guys, I gotta take a leak, so I'll join you in just a couple minutes.
Come on, Bob. It's just me and you for a few minutes. I don't really sense any kind of activity in here.
I see nothing. I see nothing. But a nice gentleman, girl. Hey, we may.
What are you looking at, Bob? I see three dogs.
I need a rainy day woman.
Love that song.
Hey, look at what he's doing.
You have the subterranean homesick blues, Bob?
I see nothing.
There does seem to be some kind of a presence that's moving these flowers.
Yeah,
very weird. Cleghorn! Hurry up and get in here! There's something moving in here!
Get out the crapper!
You see that, Bob? You see these moving?
Not really. I'm starting to feel like moving in my bowels.
Alright, Bob, let's go upstairs and see if there's any paranormal activity.
I'm tired. Almost sound like Devin C. Real there. Hey, let's go upstairs.
Alright, Bob Dylan, let's check out this room. Ow!
Hey.
This house is full of animals.
Yeah, another thing too.
Let's go in real quiet. This could be a scary experience, Bob, so be careful. You know, you've never been scared like this before. Well, Bob, it looks to me like this room is devoid of any spirit activity. That plunger just moved a little bit. It almost shimmied. Check this out. What? That curtain just moved on its own. How did that do that? Did you do that, Bob? Well, this is definitely a paranormal experience. Yeah. This curtain is moving on its own.
It's definitely not a paranormal people in there.
Shower curtain rings look weird. I wonder if these are from Del Griffith. No, his is usually plastic.
Huh. Yeah, see if there's any strings, right? But there ain't strings, there's a guy over it. Mr. Handsome Dude. Here, double, let me buy yourself a new face.
Bob, that was truly something I've never witnessed. A shower curtain moving on its own. I'm sure a curtain ring's not made or sold by Bill Griffith, shower curtain ring salesman. Let's go into this room.
I think it would have shown it in pretty soon.
They said that there was a lot of paranormal activity in this room. Well, Bob Dylan, 1960s folk music icon. I don't believe that there's any presence of any kind of entity in this room. What the devil's going on, Bob? The conveyor belt's moving.
There's more coming.
Yes, Bob, the
treadmill has started on its own. They said the wiring may be faulty, or it could be some presence of spirits. What, Bob? What? That thing's moving.
Yeah, because that thing's moving.
What are you looking at? There's nothing on here, Bob. There's a short in it or something. Look, how? Seriously, Bob. See, Bob, there's nothing on there. You know what we did? We should have got Gordon Lightfoot instead of Bob Dylan. He's a lot more clear-minded. Well, Bob, wrong again. No ghosts there. You're a disgrace to all ghost hunters. Let's go. Let's find the guys.
Hello, Jack.
I hope Claghorn's off the throne.
Gus?
Bob Dylan wants to know what year was the year that Disco Dave did the hit song to Return to Nightmare Park. What was the song in that?
It was Goodbye.
You sure?
Yes.
Not that war.
It's Goodbye.
Come on, we gotta do our findings anyway.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
Why are you guys so relaxed?
Well, lady, I slept outside in the garage on your gurney, and Claghorn here, he clogged up your stool.
But I do have some findings, Marilyn.
So what was that? Did you find anything interesting?
Hold on. If it was up to Bob Dylan, he would say that your house is haunted, but Bob Dylan is not with it, apparently. After serious review, I would conclude your house is clean.
Clean?
Your house is clean.
Are you guys absolutely sure?
Oh, we're sure, lady.
Yes, we are absolutely sure.
Well, lady, it's a matter of major coin here.
We don't normally,
you know what I'm talking about?
We don't normally bring that up,
lady.
But...
Well, I don't feel that I have to pay you if you haven't found anything.
Well, that's just tough crap.
Well, I think I'm going to have to get Tom Miller on speed dial right now.
Yeah, well, lady, he's related to Steve Miller.
He ain't no joker.
Yeah, or Midnight Toker. Bob Dylan.
Well, that was quite an experience, guys.
You know something? That was a load off my collection.
You pitch a load, didn't you, Claghorn?
I sure did.
Bob, it's been a pleasure working with you tonight.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Dillon.
Thanks a lot, Bob.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Bring it in.
What? That's sweet.
Okay.
What, Bob?
Bob? Again.
Dillon. Bob, what's... Come on, Bob.
See nothing?
Enough of this.
We're wrapping this up.
Dude,
we gotta get going.
Let's stop it, dude.
Who's that? Nobody there.
Where's everybody at?
Stew.
What's wrong, Mom?
Put it down to your window, baby.
Help me, God. I don't think twice. It's all right.
Well. It's a good thing I'm a ghost.
Well, does anyone know John Denver Norris?
Concludes our evening, and thank you for joining me. I'm Leonard Nimrod. You know, If you ever find yourself in a bizarre situation, and you're up Crip Creek without an oar, you may be fighting against the current in an uncharted river in the region of Nightmare Gallery. Live long and prosper. Peace and tranquility. Groovy baby. Ciao.